But don't you think it's strange that he hasn't called you?
Yes.
She was crying quietly. It was harder to console people over the telephone than when you could just put an arm around them. Would you like me to try and find him for you? She sobbed.
I don't know. But if you do see him, could you tell him to call me? Without fail?
Yes, of course I will. There's a possibility he's involved with the demo in Hilleren, and if things have started to come to a head there, he might be one of those chained up and therefore unable to get away. To phone you, I mean. I had sown a seed of hope in her voice.
Do you think so?
It's by no means impossible. I can go there later today. I'll look for him, and if he can't get away, I'll phone you back. With love from him. All right? I tried to sound much more optimistic than I felt, but she accepted it.
Oh, thank you so much. Then you'll... one of you'll phone.
One of us, yes. 100% certain. Take care.
Bye.
I sighed out loud as I rang off. Yet another person I was going to disappoint. Someone else I was going to bring a different message from the one she was expecting. Another seed sown that would never flower. I called Vibeke Farang. No one picked up. I called Body and Soul. She was on holiday. Then I walked home, took my car, and drove south via Skansen. The sun hit me in the eyes, like the scepter of some insane monarch. Summer had seized up, a sign that the times were in disarray. I was on my way to talk to Siv.